We've set ourselves a little challenge trying to get to the city's hotspots using the transportation available. Now, it'd be easy for me to do it because eu falo português. I speak Portuguese and I've been here before. What we need for this challenge is someone who's never been to Rio before and doesn't speak the language. I know exactly who we're going to get. Harry, this is our producer Harry here with me in Rio. You're a football fan, right?
Yeah,
he is.
Of course.
That's good. You've never been to Rio before, correct?
Well, no.
But surely you speak some Portuguese?
Not really, but I mean,
okay,
I can try.
Great, you're perfect for this. Let's go. First stop on our adventure, the Maracanã Stadium. And Harry didn't take long to find out that the easiest and cheapest way to get there was by using public transport. We were told to get a bus into town. The process was smooth and the bus looked to be part of one of the new fleets that have just been purchased with the World Cup in mind. Overall, the Brazilian government has invested $4 billion in transport infrastructure. And now into the metro, a couple of stops away from the Maracanã. Another 40 minutes, another $1.50,
yep.
And the Maracanã awaits. One of the most iconic football arenas on the planet, the Maracanã has been around since 1950. Renovations cost a fortune, around $500 million. Overall, $3.4 billion has been spent on building or renovating 12 World Cup stadiums. Next stop, Christ the Redeemer. We decided to take a cab to get up to the top of the Corcovado mountain to see this world-famous statue. From the Maracanã all the way up here in a cab, a little over half an hour.
Yeah, I mean, it would take longer at the World Cup because there'd be a lot more people around. But to see something like this,
unbelievable,
once in a lifetime.
Right?
Yeah, once in a lifetime.
The next spot we're really looking forward to going, which Rio is renowned for all around the world. We know the beaches are good, but there's one specifically, Copacabana.
Next up, another trip on the metro to avoid the traffic and get to the beach. A 10-minute walk later, we got to Copacabana and decided to sit down at one of the many little cafes facing the ocean.
Obrigado. So under 2.5 hours, under $40 to get to Copacabana after those stops we made. How would you describe your experience?
Well, even as someone who doesn't speak any Portuguese, never been to Rio before, as we know, I mean, we've been across three hotspots that everyone will go to at the World Cup next year, and it really wasn't that difficult.
And I know this is just a snapshot of the whole country, but it does bode well for the World Cup next year. So it'd be pretty fair to say that people coming here will have an unforgettable experience. And you know what? We've earned a drink, right?
I think we have.
Okay.
I certainly think we have.
Cheers.
Cheers.